In part three of our lesson on angle relationships and similar triangles, we're going to focus on the study of similar triangles. So when two triangles are similar, two results become true. We have corresponding angles are congruent, meaning their measures are equal to each other. And secondly, the corresponding sides are proportional to each other, which means they'll be in the same ratio. If we look at this first example, we have triangle APN is similar to triangle CRY, and we have to name all the congruent or proportional parts. So we use the similarity statement to help us do that. So you have to go in the order of the letters given. Letter A comes first in the first triangle, so then angle A from the first triangle is going to correspond to angle C in the second triangle, which tells us that angle A and angle C are going to be equal to each other. The second letter is P, and that will correspond to the second letter R. So that tells us that angle P and angle R are equal to each other. And lastly, we have N corresponding to Y, so angle N is going to equal angle Y. Now, secondly, we have to name the corresponding sides that are proportional. And once again, you have to use the letters in the similarity statement. So the side that starts at point A and stops at point P. So if we come in the first triangle, start at A, stop at P, that is side N. And side N will be proportional to the side that goes from the first to second letter in the second triangle, so from C to R. So from C to R is letter Y. Coming back to the first triangle, we would use the side starting from P and going to N. So starting at P and going to N is side A. And that will correspond to the side starting at R and going to Y in the next triangle. So that will be side C. And then lastly, we use the first and third letters. So we have A to N in the first triangle is side P, and C to Y in the second triangle is side R. So notice that the sides don't equal each other, but they are in proportion. Side N is to side Y, as side A is to side C, as side P is to side R. In your geometry class, you learned the angle-angle property, which states that if two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle, then the two triangles are similar to each other. Now we can abbreviate this using AA for angle-angle. The little arrow here stands for the word implies. So what this is saying is that if you have two angles that are equal to each other, two sets of angles, then that implies your two triangles will be similar. So we get to use this theorem to prove that two triangles are similar. In this example, we're asked to determine if the two triangles are similar, and if so, write the similarity statement. We can see from the picture that we have angle N and angle R are equal to each other. And we also have that angle E and angle A are equal to each other. So, in other words, that's our angle-angle. Two sets of angles are equal So that's going to give us that the triangles are similar to each other. So if we call the first triangle, triangle NED, we could name it in any order that we want to. It's the second triangle where we have to be careful, because we have to make sure that we put the corresponding parts in there. So then the second triangle, the first letter has to correspond to N. So we know N corresponds to R, so that's the first letter that we put in the second triangle. Then we have to say letter E in the first triangle corresponds to A in the second triangle. And then finally, the last letter is D, and it will correspond to the last vertex left, which is T. So triangle NED is similar to triangle RAT. Now in this next example, we have a tree whose height is unknown casts a 15-foot shadow at the same time that a 4-foot-tall stick standing vertically casts a 1-foot-3-inch shadow. How tall is the tree? Now, with any application problem, you want to take your time and approach it going just a small piece at a time. So if we look at the first part of this, we have the tree of unknown height. So we know that's going to be a variable, and it's casting a 15-foot shadow. So we can draw the ground here. Let's give ourselves horizontal ground, and then we'll put a tree, which we know trees grow vertically, so we'll get the tree going here. And you know, maybe here's the top of our tree, whatever we want to do. Okay. Now, you can assume that trees are perpendicular to the ground, so we'll label that. And we know that the shadow of a tree is going to be caused by the sun hitting the top of the tree and causing a shadow. And then this length will be 15 feet. Now the tree, we don't know the height of, so we're going to call that X. Now we have another piece of information. We're given that there is a 4-foot-tall stick, so of course it's standing somewhere on the ground, and we know the height of the stick is 4 feet, and it's standing vertically. We'll assume the stick is shorter than the tree. We can put in the relationship here, perpendicular. And we know the sun is going to hit the stick at the same angle. Going to come down here. And we're given that the shadow that the stick forms is 1 foot 3 inches. Okay, now this is going to turn out to be, we hope, an application of similar triangles. But remember, to know that we have similar triangles, we first have to know that we have two sets of equal angles. Now we know the right angle here is going to equal the right angle here. We also know that the angle of the sun is the same for both. So we know that this angle will equal this angle. So we have two angles from this triangle are equal to two angles in this triangle. So by angle-angle, we know we're going to have similar triangles. Once we have similar triangles, we know that that means that the sides are proportional to each other. So now we have to get the corresponding sides. So the height of the tree is going to correspond to the height of the stick. So we can say x is to 4 as the length of the shadow, 15 feet, is to the length of this shadow. Now, the shadow is 1 foot 3 inches, and we're going to need to convert that to the same units as all the rest of the units. And since the rest of the units are all in feet, we might as well convert this to feet. If we have 3 inches and we want to convert that into feet, we can multiply by a conversion factor that there are 12 inches in 1 foot. And now we know 3 goes into 12 4 times, so that would be 1/4 of a foot. Or if you prefer, you can write that as a decimal, 0.25 feet. So that means 1 foot 3 inches is equal to 1.25 feet, and that would be the number we would use in our proportion. To solve this proportion, we could cross multiply, but since we have x in the numerator already, all we really need to do is take the 4 and cross multiply it up times the 15. So we would get x is going to be equal to 4 times 15 divided by 1.25. And when we do that calculation, we discover that x is equal to 48, and remember the units of all of these. This was 4 feet, this was 15 feet. If we write those in, so the units of our answer is going to be feet.